Welcome to the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name's Ryan Speck. Today we're going to be taking a look at the Rockwood Mini Light 2304KS. Today we're going to take a look in detail at the 2304KS. Briefly, just want to go over some of the things that make Rockwood the number one selling fiberglass travel trailer ever here in the United States. Number one, vacuum bonded sidewalls. That's going to be true on the sidewalls of your slide out as well. Rockwood goes the extra mile when it comes to the construction of their coach because they want it to last a lifetime for you. They even vacuum bond your roof. 100% aluminum framing, your roof trusses are aluminum, everything is double welded at every joint as well. Then the flooring, all 5/8 tongue and groove marine grade plywood. One of the reasons that Rockwood is the best selling fiberglass coach on the market. Here at the Great Outdoors RV Company, we always bring in our mini lights with a power tongue jack on them. So no more cranking up here. Also has a light on it, which is great because you're not always hooking up and unhooking in the middle of the day. There is a manual override in case you run out of juice so you can still hook it up or unhook it from your tow vehicle. Right behind me, you've got two of the 30-pound propane tanks. Quick access to them as well. Just by opening up this cover, you can open up your tanks, you can close your tanks. You don't have to remove that whole cover to do it. Right behind that's where your battery is gonna sit. Plenty of room for two 12-volt deep cycle marine grade batteries, or if you wanted more amp hours, you can go with a couple of 6-volt batteries run in series. It also has a battery disconnect right below those propane tanks, which is a great feature because your propane detector, your smoke detector, they're all constantly going to have a little pull on the battery. So in order to not drain that battery to dead, you just flip that battery disconnect into the off position. Right behind me, we've also got it all set up and pre-wired for solar panels. So if you decide to do solar, it's just a plug and play process. I sell them anywhere from 40 to 160 watts in my parts store. They fold up into their own little briefcase carrying case and they have their own little stands so you can kind of maximize the light they're getting throughout the day. Right behind me, you've got a little bit of storage. This coach does feature the Murphy bed, so you don't have the traditional pass-through storage, but if you look right here, you do have a little bit of storage that does go all the way through, and I'll kind of point out to you where that's at when we get inside, because that is beneath the couch that the bed Murphy's right over. Right behind me, you've got your entry door, nice big grab handle, and up above that, you'll notice you got the power awning with a full strip of LED lights that runs the full length of the awning. Gets nice and bright, but it doesn't get hot, so it's not going to attract the bugs. Right behind me, you'll see we've got the frameless automotive style window. Nice thing about this is your rubbers aren't going to be exposed, your seals aren't going to be exposed to the weather, and then this guy does open by cranking out from the bottom. So if it's a light rain and not a lot of wind, you can still get that cross ventilation by leaving that window open. You also have outdoor speakers that'll play off your interior sound system. It is a Bluetooth capable system, so you can actually be out at the campfire listening to music off your phone. Right beside me, you've got this little rail here because this coach does come with a barbecue grill that'll hook on there and a little prep table hooks on next to it. Quick connect to your propane right here. So you've got an outdoor kitchen, but you're not sacrificing any interior space for it. And that first storage compartment I pointed out to you, the perfect size for the prep table and that barbecue grill. Right here, you've got a mount, the same mount your TV's on inside. So if you wanted to bring it out here, you've got a hookup to your antenna and you've also got power here. Now, one of the best features on the Rockwood is what's called the torsion flex axles. So most of the industry uses a leaf spring, which will provide independent suspension on each axle. But with the torsion flex axles, each wheel is actually independently suspended. So it's going to pull better. The tread life is going to last longer on the tires. It's just a overall smoother ride for the coach. We also do bring them in filled with the nitrogen. Unlike an oxygen molecule, the nitrogen molecule will not change its size with varying temperatures, so it'll help you maintain a consistent tire pressure. There's so many features on the Rockwood, it's hard to say which one's my favorite, but the 10,000 gallon water filtration system is definitely a very great feature on it. So you've got this cartridge here that holds a water filter that'll filter all the water in this coach down to 0.9 microns. So whether you're hooked up to a connection at a park or you're going out of your tank and your water pump, all your water is going to get filtered down to 0.9 microns. Another really cool thing about that is you don't got to haul the weight of that water with you. Get as close to camp as possible, then fill up your holding tank knowing that it's all going to be filtered to a residential grade. Right here you've got the city water connection, so if you're at a park or something of that nature that offers a water hookup, that's where you'd hook up. And then this is an antifreeze inlet. right inside by your water filter, there's a couple toggles that you can hit to bypass your tanks and your hot water heater. Hook a hose up to that, drop it in your antifreeze bucket, kick on the water pump. It's gonna suck that through all the lines to help you winterize your coach. You do also have pre-wire for the backup camera system. It's the Furion backup camera, and it does come with a wireless monitor that'll go in the tow vehicle with you so you can see what you're backing up to and stuff. It'll automatically come on when you put the tow vehicle in reverse. It does have a full walk-on roof because it is vacuum bonded just like the sidewalls. So we do bring it in with a really nice ladder on the back so you can get up there every 3 or 4 months, check your seals, check the rubber on your roof, make sure everything's still in top-notch shape. Then as we rotate around here to the driver's side, you will notice you've got a 6-gallon hot water heater here. So this guy is a direct spark ignition hot water heater. What that means for you is you just hit the button inside. You don't have a pilot light to light or anything here on the outside, gas or electric, and it's gonna recover at about 16.2 gallons an hour for you, even though it is just a 6-gallon tank. So that's about 15, 20 minutes, and you can have that whole tank nice and warm again. You've also got the black tank flush hookup on this. This is great for rinsing out your black tank once you're at the end of the trip. You dump your tank, hook a hose up to that. There's actually built-in little sprayers in the tank to help rinse off the sensors and stuff so that you can clean out your black tank. You've also got the nice outdoor shower right here located next to it. It's essentially a hot and cold faucet here on the outside for rinsing yourself, the kiddos, dishes, anything of that nature off on the outside of the coach without having to get all that stuff into your gray tank. Here's the gravity fill spot for your tank. So if you're gonna be going somewhere without a water hookup, this is where you would fill up your fresh tank. The back of your refrigerator has got a little line out for condensation. And then you do have the power cord hookup. It's a 30 amp cord that comes with it. It's 25 feet and that does come with the coach. And then you've also got an inlet for both cable and satellite in case you had your own portable or if you were at a park that offered that. Now, one of the most important things to consider when you're looking at a coach is what your tow vehicle is capable of towing. So it's important to know what the weights of the coach are. Most coaches, you'll find the gross vehicle weight listed right here on the front driver's side. This guy comes in at 5,876 pounds gross weight. Now, the dry weight on this coach, which is what it weighs as it sits here without any water or any cargo on board, is just under 4,400 pounds. So still a pretty light coach. Pretty much any half ton on the market out there today can tow this coach. Now, the difference between your dry weight and your max weight, that is going to be the cargo carrying capacity, what you can put on board. Come on inside and we'll check out some of the features inside this 2304 KS. One of the first things you'll notice as you look around inside of the Rockwood, really nice appointments on everything. Your window balluses are a great treatment. All this is real wood. It's not foam covered in veneer or anything like that. Now, one of the coolest things that Rockwood does is what's called the Murphy bed. It's one of the only ways you can get a coach this size and still have a couch as well as a regular bed. So simply put, all you have to do is kind of futon flat your couch. And I did want to point out, this is that under bed or under couch storage that I showed you. There's a door to access on the outside. You can get to that in here just by kind of tipping up the couch. Then once you lay that couch flat, you pop a couple pins and you've got a queen bed that'll come down for you. There's a couple really nice gas pistons to help assist with the lowering and raising of it, so it's not super heavy. A couple straps to hold all your linens in place so you're not making and unmaking the bed every time. So when it's bedtime, you've got it. You've got the queen size, well, camper queen 60 by 74 bed. And then when it's not time for sleeping, you just fold that puppy up out of the way and you set up your couch and you've got a really nice seating area here in the main part of the coach. A little bit of a wardrobe closet on each side of the bed as well. So you got some spot for hanging here. You also got a little nightstand on each side of the bed as well as a little drawer for storage. They do a good job also of providing power on each side of the bed. Now on this side, you've got a 12 volt outlet. So it's got some USB ports and a car lighter style charger as well as a regular 110 outlet. Then on this side, they actually locate that plug just on the side of this nightstand here. So both sides of the bed do have power. That's the only side that gets the 12 volt outlet though. Now as we rotate around into the kitchen, the KS is because this is a kitchen slide out. With that, you've got a ton of counter space here. One of the things I hear a lot from customers, where do I put my coffee pot? Where do I put my coffee pot? Well, you've got a perfect spot right here to set that coffee pot and you've got power there as well. You've got a pretty good storage pantry next to your kitchen as well. This is also part of that slide out. Right next to that, you've got your microwave. Pretty good sized microwave too for a coach this size. Below that, you've got a really big sink. So it's a double basin sink here with a nice high rise faucet on it. And then behind me, you've got the glass cover on the three burner stovetop. It gives you extra prep space, but it'll also serve as your backsplash when it's time to cook. And then below that, you've got the oven. All of this will run off your LP system or your liquid propane system. Above that, you've got a hood. This is really cool because it's actually vented out. You'll get a lot of makes that'll have a hood in there and it's just a fan. It doesn't actually vent anything outside the coach. So you'll still deal with, you know, the fish smell or, you know, what the fryer smell, whatever, what have you, depending on what you were cooking. But Rockwood actually vents this to the outside of the coach. Above that hood, you've got some real deep storage as well. So a great spot for all your canned goods and stuff right above the hood. A little bit of a pantry here off to the left-hand side of the stove as well. Not lacking on storage when it comes to the kitchen here in the Rockwood Mini Light. Right behind me, you've also got the refrigerator, and we do bring that in with nice raised wood panels on it, so it kind of matches all your cabinetry and stuff. This particular wood is in the maple wood decor. You can also get it in a darker wood called driftwood. Right behind me, you'll notice you've got your dinette. So comfortably easy to sit four people. Also, we'll make into a second sleeping area if you need it. The bed just kind of, or excuse me, the table just kind of goes down and you use the cushions to fill it in to make it a bed. Really big storage drawer on this side as well. And then on the opposite side, they've given you a door to access the storage under there. Now you can pull up all your cushions and stuff to get to that, but it's a little bit easier to have the door here or just have a drawer that pulls out. Right above your dinette is where your sound bar and your television will sit. And then right next to that is gonna be your CD player, DVD player, indoor outdoor speakers like I was telling you about. And it is a Bluetooth capable system. It's also got an HDMI port in case you had a game system or even a Blu-ray player or something you wanted to bring along. That way you can plug it right into here and it'll hook up to the television. And then right behind me is where your thermostat's at. So this is gonna be hot or cold, just like at your house. You simply set it onto the temperature you want it to be, and whether it kicks on the furnace or kicks on the AC, that's gonna help maintain the temperature throughout the coach. All right, welcome to the bathroom here on the 2304KS. First thing you probably noticed, you got a really nice glass enclosure here on the shower, and it does magnet together the full length of this opening, so it really prevents any water from getting out of the shower. Right next to me, you've got a huge, huge linen closet. Plenty of room for extra toilet paper, towels. Even if you needed to put some extra bedding in there, you've got it. And then the way that they've located the stool in this one, plenty of room when you're sitting at the stool. You're not gonna be banging your knees on stuff or anything of that nature. Lots of room here. It's just a great setup. And then up above me, you'll see you do have the max air ventilation fan. So that'll exhaust over 900 feet of air a minute. And we do bring it in with a really nice max air cover on it. So you can leave that vent open and the fan going even when you're headed down the road. One other thing that I always hear in a coach, not enough wardrobe space, never enough places for my wife to hang all her stuff. Well, here in the bathroom, they supplement extra wardrobe space. So not only do you have the two next to the bed, but you've also got this area here to hang up extra clothes and a nice shelf up above it too for any of your folded items, jeans, things of that nature. Right over here, you've also got a really nice size sink for a bathroom. They give you a little toothbrush and a soap holder. This is an actual medicine cabinet, not just a mirror hanging on the wall. And then you've even got some storage down below the sink. So definitely not lacking on storage in this 2304KS. Thanks for taking the time to look at the Rockwood Mini Light 2304KS with me today here at the Great Outdoors RV Company. My name is Ryan Specht. If you have any questions, feel free to send me an email, ryan@thegreatoutdoorsrv.com, or go ahead and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Anytime we get new units in, we'll get some videos and put them up for you. If you have any questions at all, don't hesitate to shoot me an email or just comment right here in the comments section. Thanks for stopping by.